Hello, here we are. And it's the end of the season, the last game of the season. This is going to be an historical moment because San Marino is going to face Juventus for the cup final. As you can see, we've been on a very interesting run of results lately. The last two games were not so successful. I have to say that due to the schedule year being so close, we played against Bologna with our second team. So just to be sure that our first team would be ready for the cup final, so there it can be that we will have an advantage there. But with that said, let's go for the game. Let's go for the final, and let's see how it will go. I have hopes for this game. It's going to be very difficult, no doubt, but we will give it a try. So you can see that pretty much everyone is in a good shape. We have René in the goal, Fiamozzi on the right, Nastase on the left, Garcia and Calabrese will play in the center, Frediani on the right of the midfield, Lestiene on the left of the midfield, Gagliardini in the middle, Guaira attacking midfield, Aguirre and Jurdjevic up front. This is going to be our lineup. It's going to be a very hard game. Juventus are clear favorites for this game, but we will try and have a word to say here. Juventus plays with Rajkovic in goal, Widmer on the right, Adnan on the left, Bonucci and Maes in the center, then Ontiveros on the right, Coman on the left, João Mário and Pereira on the center, up front Cookie and Williams. Interesting. We will have on the bench Falcone, Cristini, Correa, Gullin, De Luca, Petagna, Loporto, Manai. And Juventus, they have on the bench Klaassen, Goldaniga, Berardi, Abubakar, Rose, Zanandrea, Aubameyang, Vailati, Mandzukic, Latorre, Marquisio and Gerbo. These are the lineups, so we are ready for the cup final, and here we go. Here we go for the cup final. Let's see how what happens. Can San Marino make history? It's the second final we are in. The first final was almost 5 years ago, when we were in the final of the Serie D Cup. If you remember, we lost that one on penalties. Let's see how this one will go. We are playing in the Olimpico Stadium in Rome, so let's see. So far, nothing happens. Garcia sees a yellow card. Guaira with the free kick. Nastase crosses, goal! Lestiene scores the first goal of the final. Well done, Lestiene. He hasn't scored lots of goals during the season, but what an important goal now. And let's see if we can really come on top of the game, or if Juventus will rebound. I am kind of confident because due to the fact that I rested my first team on the last game, my team should be well rested in the long run. So we should be more fit for the 90 minutes, but Juventus is a very strong team, and they sure can score goals against us. Oi, very well, very well. Fiamozzi, René, Nastase, everything under control. Gagliardini, Guaira, Djurdjevic. Here comes Djurdjevic. Djurdjevic almost loses the ball, but passes to Guaira, finds Fiamozzi on the right, he crosses, and it's a goal! Lestienne scores the second goal. And it's going to be, we are going to be the winners of the cup. Well, it's still too soon, but it kind of looks like. And again, I'm confident for the second half because my team should be a bit more rested compared to Juventus. Nastase Gagliardini, Gagliardini, Guaira, Aguirre, Aguirre finds Lescaut, Lestienne. What a game for Maxime Lestienne. Maxime Lestienne, he is being the hero of the cup. He is going to be in the history of San Marino Calcio as the hero of our first big trophy, Maxime Lestienne. And I am kind of thinking that I want to replace him, but maybe let's see if he's tired or not. But I will replace him for the applause before the end of the game. So let's do some replacements. And it's Fiamozzi a bit tired. Do we have Nika? No, we don't have Nika. So what we can do is Calabresi can play on the right, and we can play Cristini on the center. Then Guaira is also tired, so Correa is going to play today. And in a couple minutes, I will also get Lestienne out for the applause. Maybe on the 75 minutes. That's what I am thinking. On the 75 minutes, I'm going to get Lestienne for the applause. But watch out, Juventus is still around. But well done, Calabresi controlling the play. Correa. Correa with the ball, he tries to find, but it's a poor pass. It's a poor pass from Correa. Oh, well done. No, Juventus has the ball. Cookie. A cookie can be dangerous. No, well covered. Very well defended. Oh, it's offside. Aboubakar was offside there. And here comes Lestiere and Nastase again, the left wing today. Very active today. It's Cristini with the ball. Correa, he has a good line for Calabresi and Djurdjevic. Djurdjevic scores. Delighted, Djurdjevic. And I'm really thinking like on getting Lestienne out for the big applause, which I'm going to do soon enough. And it's now, it's now. So Lestienne is going out, Gullin is going in. It's the big applause for Lestienne. I hope the stadium stands in applause because Maxime Lestienne sure deserved it. And it's practically done. Maybe Juventus can score one goal, maybe not. But it's done. It's done. The Italian Cup is won. The Italian Cup is won by San Marino. San Marino Calcio just won the Italian Cup. Well done by Cristini controlling the play. Then, René still has the chance to save. Yeah, René also showing his ability there. The game is almost over. Yeah, should be ending at any moment. 89 minutes, nothing else to do. It's done. San Marino won the cup. We won the cup. There is no doubt. Juventus had no chance. It's done. The celebrations will start. We won the cup. Congratulations, everyone. It's done. Yeah, we were pretty much superior during the game. I think the option of resting the first 11 on the last game really worked to our advantage here today. So it's a win, yeah. San Marino lifts Italian Cup. San Marino wins the Italian Cup for the first time in our history. Fans, yeah, San Marino gets half a million. Yeah, my name is on everyone's lips. Yeah, the boss is pleased. Lestienne, yes, he had a great game. San Marino qualifies for Euro Cup. We were already qualified for Euro Cup, so that's not a surprise. Bonus for our players. And it's done, it's done. By the way, if you want to know, now that the season is ended, we ended in the fifth position. So, well inside European competition. And looking into our squad, we can now probably watch the overall. And you can see that Falcone played quite well in the goal. He currently looks like this. He is still developing. René, okay, let's watch Venturini. Venturini is for sale, I don't want him. René, he played quite well, also he was once the best man of the match. He looks like this, a very interesting player, but probably reaching the end of his career. Well, at least he's at full potential. Kevin Renish is playing for the youngsters, the goalkeeper. He is like this. For San Marino, he's okay. He did not play for the national team yet, but I think there's not much else coming from him. Fiamozzi played very well. 10 assists. Very well from Fiamozzi. He looks like this. Then Nika played 18 games, 1 goal, 3 assists. Played quite well. He is looking like this. Actually, at the moment, decreasing attributes, but okay. Cicorelli, a young player, he is not developing that well. I don't believe he's going to get anywhere. Paul Garcia played 25 games, 3 assists, played very well. Paul Garcia, he's still 25 years old. He looks like this. He's a good player, very interesting player. Alessio Loporto, he played 22 games, 8 assists, 3 goals, played very well. He is looking like this. Great left back, I believe. Very interesting left back. Mohamed Mensah played 24 games, 1 goal, played quite well also. He looks like this. He's still 22 years old, so very young player. An interesting center back. Yeah, he is probably one of our, maybe our best center back. Cristinel Nastase, 21 games, 7 assists, played well. He looks like this and still increasing, so he is developing very well into a very interesting player and still only 20 years old, so there's more to develop from Nastase. Then we have this guy, Manuel Podeschi. Manuel Podeschi, he was a new youngster who came this year, 16 years old. I have some hopes for this guy. He is already a product of our new training youth facilities, so Some hopes. In Bimbo also came this year, but I don't have so many hopes for him. Calabresi, a center defender, played 20 games, 1 goal, 3 assists, played well. He looks good enough center back. Then Cristini played 18 goals, played okay. He looks also an interesting center back. The thing with Cristini is that his contract is ending and our board still did not give him a new contract, so maybe he's going to leave. Maybe. We will see. Daniele Davi, I don't want him, so he is for sale. Bianchi is still trying to develop and he's already playing for San Marino, 4 caps already, a center back for San Marino. Gallorini is trying to develop but not a good player at all. Zanotti is another San Marino player, 5 caps. I don't think he will develop much more, but he is already a player who can play for San Marino. Bidawi, Sufiane Bidawi, he is the same as ever, and he is already signed by Lecce, so he's going to leave on the next free transfer. Giuseppe De Luca, 9 goals, 3 assists, 6 times the best man of the match, played very well, De Luca. De Luca looks like this. I don't think he has more room to develop, but he is a very interesting player. Adrian Stojan, I don't want him, I'm trying to sell him, let's see if I can. He still played 5 games, scored 4 goals, 3 assists. He actually played well, but I don't want him anymore. Pagliarini, another player I don't want anymore, so he did not play. Axel Gullin, he had 7 goals, 1 assist, played well. Axel Gullin, he is developing something, so there's hope, he's still 24 years old. Aldo Lorenzi, Lorenzi is a young player. I don't think he's going to reach much more, but we will see. Lorenzi is an Italian guy. Matteo Bonato, another Italian guy. Another guy that I don't believe will reach Serie A level. Marco Rubetti is another Italian guy. I don't like him, so I don't think he's going to go far. Valerio Verre, he played 20 games, 2 assists, played well. Verre, he currently looks like this. Very, very interesting player, very complete player. He's a great center midfield. Roberto Gagliardini did 3 assists, played even better than Verre, played 23 games. He is looking like this. Also, a very complete center midfield. Very interesting for the center midfield position. Vittorio Pedretti, he is a San Marino player, 6 caps already. I don't think he's going to improve much more, but we will see. Daniele Bugli, an Italian player. Nah, I don't believe nothing will come from this guy. Maxime Lestienne, the hero of the cup, 6 goals, 3 assists, played okay. Lestienne looks like this, a very interesting player. Then we have Marco Frediani. 12 goals, 6 assists, played very well. Frediani, here he is, an interesting player. Di Mariano, we want to sell him, so I don't believe in Di Mariano. Joaquim Correa, 2 goals, 4 assists. He looks a very, very promising player. I actually like him a lot. Petagna is a striker, scored 8 goals, 2 assists, played well, and is now developing something. So there's hope. There's hope he's still going to. He's already a very interesting player, and there's hope he will become even better. Manai scored 10 goals, 3 assists, played quite well. He developed a bit this season. There's hope he will develop more. He's still 23, so there's room for improvement. Djurdjevic scored 11 goals, 4 assists, played quite well. This is how he looks like. He's an interesting striker. Aguirre scored 8 goals, 2 assists, played okay. Aguirre is also a very interesting striker. Then we have Fortunato de Canio, the guy who pretty much stopped improving, so I believe he's not going to reach Serie A level. Guaira scored 4 goals, 4 assists, played very well, and he is developing into a very impressive player. Only 19 years old, Guaira. Then we have Tomassoni. Tomassoni, we are trying to develop Tomassoni. I don't know if he's going to get anywhere. And Muccioli, 16 years old. We are also trying to develop this guy for San Marino. We will see where he gets. Now, with this said, I'm going to show you how my assistant manager thinks about these players. So, if we see on potential, the players with most potential are Garcia, Abit, Loporto, Mensah, Nastase, Calabresi also has lots of potential, De Luca also, here Gullin is seen as a player with lots of potential, Verre obviously, Gagliardini a bit, Lestiene a lot, Frediani a lot of potential, Correa, Petagna, Manai, Djurdjevic, and Guaira is a top potential player at 19 years old, so we will see how it develops. As for the youngsters, if you have seen nothing really special, we have here this guy Podeschi with 2 stars potential. So this is the best we have. Lorenzi also 2 stars. Pedretti here almost 2.5 stars. And De Canio almost 2.5 stars also, I think. So this is how it looks. The season has ended. You can see here that we have training facilities being improved in this is in 5 months. We have a new stadium coming only next season. It's still 1 year till we have the new stadium. So we will see if we can convince the board to keep improving stuff. Our finances look quite okay, quite well balanced. Things are looking great. San Marino is developing. Our aim for next season is keep ourselves in European competitions and try and reach the Champions League. We will see. See you guys. Bye.